Hi, Con. To start, would you please provide our audience with an introduction of yourself and a little bit about your background in L&D?
Sure can, Guy. I have a PhD in instructional psychology and technology. I finished that in 1984, a long time ago. And one of the three areas of focus in my graduate work was measurement. And I knew that that was really important because if you can't measure what you've done, what do you have? You know, really. And so I did some specialized work at graduate work in that area. And then I went into the real world to work in 1984. And measurement has been a core focus of my work since then.
Well, thank you. Now for our main event. Would you please give our audience your 5 to 10 minute take on what to measure and how to measure the impact of instruction in an enterprise learning context?
I'd love to, Guy. Let me share a few slides with you. So measuring business impact, there are three questions that I want to take on in answer to your questions, Guy. And the first is, so why has it been so difficult to measure the impact of what we do? Because it has been. I've walked into hundreds of organizations working with them on this challenge, and it's difficult. And I want to just talk about that briefly. And then I do want to focus in on what can we measure in this new environment of workflow learning particularly, and then how do we do it? Now, I'm not going to be able to, in 5 to 10 minutes, go deep, but I do want to give you a high-level view of the answers to these three questions, and then I'll provide you a way to ask other questions, all of you, to the degree that you'd like. So, why has it been so difficult? It's because there's a gaping hole between what we do in learning and business impact. And so we've gone after the wrong kinds of data. You know, how many people did we train and other kinds of traditional metrics. But also all we've been able to do is correlate what we do in learning because it's disconnected really from what it has been, at least, from what people are doing actually in their work. Gloria Geary in 1990 wrote a little book on embedded performance support solutions. And in that work, she talks about measurement. She actually wrote an article around that same time, why don't we just weigh them? Because she said the traditional metrics associated with learning, just why not just bring in a cattle way of measuring cattle and measure our students, weigh them, and then weigh them after the learning. She thought that would be actually more effective. But what she actually proposed in the 90s was that an embedded performance support system, a digital coach tied to and blended with our learning that will go with the learner from their learning experience and support them in the flow of work, because that's embedded in the performance zone where people are actually doing their work, that it provides us the ability to gather data and to monitor and to see what people are doing in ways that we have never been able to do that. And that was in the 90s. But we haven't seen a lot of movement on that insight until the last decade. And in this last decade, as our capacity to and ability to build and push performance support into the flow of work, following the principles of embedded performance support, we're able to do some amazing things. For example, we can measure business impact in these five areas. Now, underneath each of these are some tactical impact that we can truly measure, because we have an embedded performance support system in the flow of work. We can begin to monitor what people are doing, as long as we're making sure that we have designed that embedded performance support system in the right way. Isn't that a powerful thing, Guy? To be able to systematically connect what we do with these kinds of outputs, these kinds of impact, this kind of impact.
Yes.
We just not too long ago worked with a client that has a worldwide footprint. And they had the challenge of it taking 18 months to get their people up to speed and proficient in their work. And they were leaving those people that they were training, it was taking 18 months, they were leaving around that time. That is, their attrition was at about 18 to 24 months. So we created a digital coach or an embedded performance support system. We brought that into the training. We merged that into that blend of workflow learning with traditional learning. We targeted the critical impact skills in our formal learning, and then used the EPSS to help them integrate and move that. And we blended that workflow learning and performance support with learning. The first year, we found that it took now only 9 months to get to that, actually a greater level of productivity and performance than the previous, with less oversight and more powerful performance. And then this year, it's looking like that they're going to be down to 6 months, you know, from an 18 months. So that's and we're able to measure that. We're able to gather that data because we have something there working and helping people transition from the formal learning into their flow of work. So Gloria, this was her insight. This is the insight that we need to all have. It is much easier to actually employ the assessments in a performance support environment. And because it's in that work context and it's direct and it connects the dots. So how do we do it? Well, it begins by fundamentally making performance visible. In this journey of workflow learning, what we found is that organizations at a high level have mapped the workflow, but at the tactical level, they just haven't been able to connect that. We have a process that we follow called rapid workflow analysis, where we actually map what it is that people do at the job task level. So here, for example, in assess challenges, you can see the job tasks there, or in create, you can see these are the tasks. And so we make performance visible at that tactical level. And then we build an EPSS around those tactical, that tactical work. It's task-based performance support. And that brings us to a second fundamental principle of getting to measurement. And that is that you then need to build your digital coach or EPSS infrastructure to support measurable performance at that job task level. And so we have what we call the performance support pyramid, which is a way of organizing information into an EPSS. 2 clicks, 10 seconds, you need to get to all the information that I need to have for any job task. And then I need, at that job task, I need 2 clicks, 10 seconds to be able to get to a high level set of steps and then drive down into the detail of those steps to the degree that I need to be able to perform effectively. And then, you know, not performance without understanding is dangerous. And so people can't make the right decisions that they need to make unless I can also have the knowledge that undergirds that performance. And so in another step, I need to be able to get to the critical, the key knowledge that I need to have and have that be supported. And then if you will, I may also need to be able to get to all of the reference resources that I need to be able for that job task, or the learning resources that I can, in another click, get to what it, help in learning if I find that I need that. And then also at the bottom of that pyramid, but not because it's so, it's less important, are people resources. We want people to be able to support themselves to the degree that they can, but have access to the people help, particularly at the moment of solve and at the moment of change. That's when people resources prove their value. So you've got to map performance, and you've got to be able to put in place a workflow learning, an EPSS infrastructure, and then you're ready to go. And what we found is that we need to measure at two levels. One is that we need to develop our ability to gather business impact data across the board. And so there's this ongoing measurement infrastructure that we have to put into place. And then on a project by project basis, we need to be able to narrow in and focus in on what that project is going to really do. So we've got to have this approach where we have an infrastructure in place that we know what it is that we're going after organizationally, and we have a strategy and the capability to gather data at those levels. And then on a project by project basis to tailor that to what that project can do. And so we've developed a four-phase approach for both of those areas. This is for developing ongoing measurement infrastructure. Well, you can see phase one through four here. We want to in the initial stages, identify which of those business impact requirements that I shared with you earlier in those five areas, what's important to us? And to what degree are those important? What are we truly going to go after on an ongoing basis, gathering that? And then we want to then have a prioritized list of impact outcomes. From that, then we've got to develop the ability to monitor usage. Now, why is that important? Because, frankly, the people choose whether they use an EPSS, and so if they are using it, it means that they are being successful in it. And because it's organized according to how people are working tactically. And we're monitoring the usage or the non-usage, and then verifying phase three, verifying that in a systematic way. That usage monitoring becomes a very powerful metric and allows us to then, in a very targeted way, verify that usage really is meaning what it needs to mean. And then we need to be able to summarize that data in a meaningful way to report, and we need to automate that to the degree possible. And all of this is doable today in the environment of workflow learning. And then narrowing down to the project impact. So on a project by project basis, this is what we do. We sit down with the key stakeholders and ask this question: So why are you coming to us? You know, generally key stakeholders come to learning and development and say, I need 2 days of training, or I need some e-learning. You know, they're prescribing that. And we acknowledge that and then step back and say, let's talk a little bit. What are the challenges that you're trying to solve? what are the opportunities that you're working on at taking advantage of? What is driving this request? And as we identify those challenges, then we ask the question, or opportunities, we ask the question, so if we successfully address this, what would the impact be, measurable impact that you would like to see? And we do that upfront. We do that upfront. And from there, then we're able to identify the baseline data that we need to gather against those measurable results. And frankly, those measurable results are generally fall within the spectrum of what we've designed and developed to do. But we need to be able to target those and then link them to real business objectives. You know, what is the business trying to achieve? And so then we develop our data gathering plan, which includes usage, but also validating that. And then we generally have to create some measures. If we've done our job over time, we generally have those measures in place that we can adapt and adjust, but they've got to be tailored to that project. I hope that makes sense. You know, really what we are about in the work that we do is delivering measurable business impact. And how do we do that? Well, we enable effective employee performance in a flow of work, and we do everything that we can to remove the barriers against that performance. That's really our work. And I appreciate, Guy, the opportunity to just rapidly fly across this measurement world that we're living in. I just want all of you to know that we can do this. And when we do this in the way that we've described, we begin to connect the dots between what we do in our profession and true business impact. Any questions you've got, please send them to admin@applysynergies.com, and we'll get right back to you with an answer to that.
Con, thanks for sharing your insights with us today.
Oh, it's my privilege. You know, this is an area of passion, and I appreciate, Guy, your opening the door to our having this discussion today.
Yes, thank you. I think our audience is going to be, it's well worthwhile pursuing this. And thank you for all you do for the field.
We're all doing our best, aren't we?
We are trying. Cheers.
Cheers.